is our God, always now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
O heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who is everywhere present, and fill us with all things, treasury of blessings, and giver of life, come and tide in us, cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls from the blood.
Holy God,
always, now, and ever, and unto ages.
appear before thee to see thy power and thy glory. For thy mercy is better than life, my lips shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee in my life, and in thy name will I lift up my hands. As with marrow and fatness let my soul be filled, and with lips rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I remembered thee on my bed, at the dawning meditated on thee. For thou art become my helper, and shelter thy wings will I rejoice. My soul pleased after thee, thy right hand hath been good to help me. But as for thee, in vain have they sought after my soul. They shall go into the nethermost parts of the earth, they shall be surrendered unto the enemy of the Lord. Fortunes for foxes shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God. Everyone shall be praised that sweareth by him, for the mouth of them is thou that speak unto the king. At the dawn they meditated on thee, for thou art my helper, and the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath pleased after thee, thy right hand hath been with me to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and into ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Both now and ever, and into ages of ages. Amen. Lord God, my salvation, by day I cry, by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, God, have my ear and my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, and my life and day is after my mind. I am counted with them that go down to the pit, and becomes a man without help, free from the dead. Like the wise of the slain that sleep in the grave, and God remembers no more, and they are cut off from thy hand. They lead me to the lowest pit, in darkness, and the shadow of death. Against thee is thine anger being strong, and all thy billows pass thy life upon me. Thou shalt leave my friends apart from me. They have made me an abomination unto themselves. I did deliver up and have not come forth. Mine eyes were grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord. The whole day long I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Name for the dead, O thou Lord of thunders. Shall physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee? Nay, shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy, and of thy truth, and thy destruction? Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. As for me and thee, O Lord, I cry, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Therefore, Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turnest thy face away from me. Poor man am I, never troubles from my youth, yea, having been exalted, or stumbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came round about in thy water all day long, they encompassed me about together. Thou shalt remove far from me, friend and neighbor, and my acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cry, and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear unto my supplication. Bless the Lord of my soul, and all that is within thee, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, forget not that he hath done to thee, who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things. And you shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. He hath made known his ways known unto Moses and unto the sons of Israel, the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord our sight, and plenteous in mercy, not unto the end of the younger, neither unto the journey will he be wrought. Not according to our iniquities have he dealt with us, neither according to our sins have he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and covering, that the Lord hath mercy, his mercy to prevail over them that fear thee. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath the Lord hath compassion upon them that fear thee. For he knoweth where we are made, he hath remembered that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he be blossomed forth. When the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, no longer will it know the place of death. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, upon them that fear him. And his righteousness upon sons of sons, upon them that keep his testament and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom be a full judgment. Bless the Lord, all of these angels, mighty in strength, that perform his word to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all ye his hosts, his ministers unto his will. Bless the Lord, all ye his works, and the purpose of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. And the purpose of his name, bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give mercy and supplication, thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness. And enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall know my living and justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat in darkness as those that belong to the dead. And my spirit within me has become despondent. Within me, my heart is strong. I remember days of old and meditate on all thy works, Cause me to have mercy in the morning, for indeed I've been with my hope. Cause me to go the way where I should walk, for indeed I've been with my soul. Rescue from my enemies, O Lord, and give me hope that I can teach me to do thy will without my God. I have a spiritual life, keep me in your way, and let this, but I can say, Lord, that thou shalt forgive. Thy righteousness shall not be mine, so I will bless him, and thy mercy shall not be mine, destroy my enemies. And thou shalt have all the benefit of my soul, I am his servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment, my servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment, my servant. Thy good spirit shall lead you in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
And peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priest and the diaconate in Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Porch, Bishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and also authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Will, Madison, Cecil, Dutton, Thaddeus, Adam, Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance out of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Fallen to remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious, many without the cross, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. Spirit, we speak divine sin. Verily, God
we may be accounted worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom and tender, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to the spirit. So they gave him a piece of broiled fish and a honeycomb, and he took and ate it before them. Then Jesus said to them, "These are my words which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ should suffer and on the third day rise from the dead, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are my witnesses of these things. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But stay in the city of Jerusalem until you are clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he blessed them, he was parted from them, and was carried up into heaven, and they worshipped him, and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and were continually in the temple, praising and blessing God. Amen. Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Remember, so I pray for my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create created me a clean heart of God and renew a right spirit in me. Cast me out of my justice and take now thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation with thy guiding spirit establish me. I shall teach the transgressors thy ways and the ungodly without penalty. Deliver me from the guiltiness of God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in the recompense of joy. Thou shalt open my lips and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, I have given over offerings thou shalt offer things. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, do thy good pleasure as desire, and let the wall of Jerusalem be built up. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and over offerings, then shall they offer bullets to come in.
Through the intercessions of our all immaculate Lady, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, by the light of the precious and life giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodies and powers of heaven, and the supplication of the honorable glorious Father, for our brother and Baptist John, of the holy glorious Paul, of all apostles, Peter, and Paul, and of all the holy apostles of our fathers, of I, the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, praise the great Gregory the theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius Cyril, and John the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra's Spirit, and Trinitas, and Lactarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers, of I, the saints, Tikhon, patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the Holy Glorious Great Martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the First Dreamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the Lateral Martyrs, Ignatius the God Terror of Antioch, Paranormals and Mysterios, of the Holy Glorious Great German Martyrs, Thecla, Mara, Anastasia, of the holy, glorious, bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who showed in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of his holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, and all-loudable Prochorus, Nicanor, Timor, and Parmenas, deacons and apostles of the 70, venerable Paul, founder of Zeropatamu and St. Paul monasteries on Athos, venerable Irene Chrysovalantu and Pithiman, Bishop of Tempo, whose memory we celebrate today with all of our saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us. Amen.
Amen. before the eyes of the apostles and was warning very finally. On this day, we also commemorate the Venerable Paul, founder of the local temple, and St. Paul, St. Paul Monastery, Venerable Irene Crucibalantu, and the Peter, Bishop of Tampa, by the intercessions of thy Savior, Christ God, and their St. Thomas.
The host of Israel, having passed the Red Sea, and watered deep with feet of moist, and having seen the priest in riders of the
pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call into remembrance, O Holy, Immaculate, most blessed, and glorious, most and apostles, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Holy is the Lord our God.
thou shalt remark thy marvelous works. The guards keeping watch over the God-bearing tomb said to the Jews, O to the ordained council, for ye sought to keep the boundaries. Vainly have ye labored, for ye thought that ye could have the resurrection, not the crucified. But ye only showed it in clear manifestation. O to your council of false opinion, why take ye counsel to hide what cannot be hidden? Better it were than ye hear of us and choose to believe in that which had happened, which is that an angel resplendent, high-flying, descended from heaven and rolled with a stone. And from fear of him we were in promise of death, and to the open very steadfast women he shouted, saying, see not the death of the guards, the unsealing of the tomb, and the emptiness of the angels. By seeking them as dead, he will abolish the victory of days and crush the throne of death. Go ye in haste and tell the glad tidings of the resurrection to the apostles, and shout ye fearlessly, saying, in truth, O Lord, possessor of great mercy, is risen.
Thank you.
the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Power and glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy, through remembrance, our all, holy Immaculate, both blessed and glorious, Lady Mary, with all saints.
Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our lives unto Christ our God.
wisdom, let us attend.
Thank you. Lord, for the godly man hath disappeared.
Wisdom.
The reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Romans.
Let us attend.
Brethren, having gifts that differ according to the grace given to us, let us use them. If prophecy, in proportion to our faith. If service, in our serving. He who teaches, in his teaching. He who exhorts, in his exhortation. He who contributes, in liberality. He who gives aid, with zeal. He who does acts of mercy, with cheerfulness. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with brotherly affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Never flag in zeal. Be aglow with the Spirit and serve the Lord. Rejoice in your hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
But Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, Why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier to say, Your sins are forgiven, or to say, Rise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins, he then said to the paralytic, Rise, take up your bed and go home. And he rose and went home. When the crowds saw it, they marveled, and they glorified God who had given such authority to men.
Spirit, one God. We heard in the epistle lesson this morning, having gifts that differ according to the grace given us, let us use them. Now, each of us has something not just that we can offer, but that we need to offer. And the title of our message, well, before I get to the title, one other thing that I love the Bible passage that talks about living stones. Because each of us is a living stone. We make up the body of Christ. And if there's a hole in the wall, that's a problem. The house doesn't stand right. All of us need to contribute and help. So the title of our message today is The Church Needs Your Gift and Why It's Okay to Be Drywall. I'll get to the drywall thing in a minute, but there's three things I want to cover today about gifts. Why is your gift needed? How we can identify our gift? and then what we do with our gift when we have it. So first, why is our gift needed? Well, I took just a minute to jot down a few notes, just looking around the church and thinking, well, what are some things that have to get done? There's a lot of stuff that has to get done to keep the church running. You know, there's the choir has to prepare music, they practice, somebody makes the holy bread, the prosphora, the church has to be clean, somebody organizes Sunday school, the teachers have to be there, they have to prepare lessons, somebody has to do the homily. And I actually have to work really hard at this. It takes me several hours of doing this. I just get up on Sunday morning and go, oh, this is what I'm gonna say. You know, somebody does the nice flowers, we have greeters, we have giving, women's fellowship, men's fellowship, outside service like focus, bulletins, schedules, somebody does the payroll, the admin, parish council, building committee, prayer partners, meal training, even washing the communion cloths. There's a lot of stuff in that. That's just a few things. When each of us contributes our gift, the church runs smoothly. And if anybody's ever driven in a car where all the cylinders aren't firing, it's pretty rugged, right? The car vibrates, the engine doesn't run smooth. All of us need to be there. All of us need to contribute. And the idea that many hands make light work, you know, I don't mind being on cleanup. I actually kind of enjoy it. But I love doing it with other people. You know, I don't want to be the only guy doing it. And when I see other people doing it, it encourages me to do more. So that's something really important. Those are just a few thoughts on why our gift is needed. But what is your gift? How can we identify it? Well, the epistle lesson gave us a list. It certainly wasn't a comprehensive list. The first one is a little bit lofty. You could be a prophet. Nicodemus, you might be a prophet. We don't know. The second one, service, teaching, exhortation. You know, we've got some good exhorters here. People contribute, people give aid, showing mercy. Now, what are some other things that might be something that would be our gift? One question to ask, what am I good at? What brings me joy? You know, that's probably a good clue as to what might your gift be. And, you know, sometimes I worry our culture, especially here in America, our Western culture, we're so distracted all the time. You know, we have so much entertainment, and it's gotten way worse in the last few decades. Now everybody's got a smartphone. Nicodemus, no? Nicodemus, good. You have good parents. They haven't given you a smartphone yet. I didn't give my kids smartphones either when they were little. Yes, he's named after a prophet. So, you know, that we don't want to be so distracted that we don't make time to really think about it, cultivate our gift. And as I look around the room here, there's many gifted and talented people. You know, let's see, let me pick on somebody here. Quentin back there? You know, Quentin, I heard a good word about Quentin the other day. Sue Braun's on the building committee, and she was on a conference call. Quentin's not actually been on the committee, but he's in the real estate business, and Sue said, man, Quentin is really a sharp guy, and he's got a lot of talent, a lot to offer. And so Quentin, good job. Thanks for offering that gift and helping. And, you know, we've got Yumi and Ruth and Alex and all the people in the choir. You know, Deacon John, he's got a gift of being a motorcycle rider, except when he crashed. But there's a lot of gifts up there, and I was just going to share a couple of personal ones for me. Well, actually, one is a gift I have, or so I've been told, and the other is a gift I don't have, that I'm not good at, or so I've been told. And the first one, those of you who know me know that I tend to like to tease a little bit. Valeska, like telling the truth? Okay. So, when my kids were little, we spent a lot of time, the Braun's, the Olsons, who Sophie Sals are in the back, her maiden name is Olson, so her family, the Giroux, Allison, and the Braun's, we did a lot of camping trips together, did a lot of time. Well, you know, I would tend to tease the kids a little bit and have fun. So Sophie's little sister, Erica, who's now married to Sean Reagan, you know, she was like, you know, Tom, why do you tease all the time? And I said, it's my calling. job is to help people be humble. And so she actually made me, I know it's a true gift because she made me this medal. This it's a gold medal. It says Orthodox Christian. I've had this for about 20 years. And it says gold medal for Deacon Tom, the humbler. Now, a gift that maybe is not one of my strengths is maybe being a hospital visitor. And my good friend over here, Bruce shares the same challenge that I have. And I don't mean to throw Bruce under the bus, but his story is just so much better than mine. I've got to share it, but this is really my weakness. So, you know, one time Lynn Marie had to go to the hospital. It wasn't an emergency. It was a scheduled thing. So Bruce takes her in, gets her checked in, and, you know, they start getting ready to put her on anesthesia. So Bruce, hey, practical guy, he goes out to the parking lot, heading off to his car, and he's going to go to work. And Colleen Allen is walking across the parking lot, and she says, you know, Bruce says, hey, Colleen, what are you doing here? And she says, oh, I'm going to be with Lynn Marie. And you know, Bruce and I aren't the brightest tools in the shed, but we eventually catch on. So, you know, the dots start connecting, and he's like, uh-oh, maybe this wasn't the best decision to go to work today. So, but he felt guilty for a few minutes, then he went to work. But I hate to say it, I did the same thing to my lovely bride, Wendy, and then the bad thing is Lynn Marie and Wendy started talking, and then they say, you know, Deacon Tom, Bruce, you guys treat us like we're a car. You know, it's like, hey, you know, she needs a tune-up, get the oil change, just take her to the mechanic, drop her off, you know, come back in a few hours, pick her up. So, okay, so maybe hospital compassion isn't my gift, but there's people like Colleen Allen that it is their gift. So it's beautiful when we do have, you know, that synergy in the church where everything works together, and it all comes together when all of us do our part. A couple brief encouragements. When you're thinking about your gift, don't compare yourself to other people. You know, sometimes, like, we take, maybe we put somebody like the priest up on a pedestal, and I mean, Father Mike, he's really cool and hip, but, you know, we shouldn't put him on an unhealthy pedestal. And I was thinking about this idea of, you know, I said the living stones at the beginning. I love the building analogy in the church, and we have a number of builders in our church, Tony and Doug Martin. I know they had to be out of town today. They're contractors. They build big, beautiful homes for people. Tony Marhofer is a construction manager for Disney. He worked on Star Wars Land and some neat stuff. I'm actually in the construction industry as a civil engineer. And, you know, I was thinking with our building here, our physical building, just think about this for a second. We've got a foundation. We've got these walls, but what's behind the walls? You know, there's 2x4s, right? There's what we call studs that run up and down. And then we got the drywall. And just picture for a second, if we didn't have the drywall, you know, we'd be looking through here, we'd be looking into the fellowship hall in the back, we'd be hearing all the screaming crazy kids, you know, little kids running around in the narthex out there. You know, it wouldn't be finished, right? It would look weird. It wouldn't be finished. So we don't tend to think of drywall as a real important thing or special, but it is. All of us are needed. All these components. And if any of us don't show up, if any of us don't offer our gift, the whole thing doesn't, it's not done. It doesn't work right. All right. So, and one other thing, if you feel really stumped on your gift, the gospel lesson today gave the ultimate fallback. And that is, you know, remember the story, the four guys brought the paralytic to Jesus. And remember what Jesus said. He said it wasn't the paralytic's faith, but it was their faith, the guys that brought him. So if you can be nothing else, if you say, oh, I'm an introvert, I'm whatever, I'm not talented, you can at least be a friend. You can be a friend, and you can participate in somebody's healing. Maybe you're just praying for a friend. I mean, I don't, you know, you can be anybody. You can pray for a friend. So don't try to convince yourself that there's not something you have to offer. And we should pray and diligently seek that gift of what God would have us do. The last thing I wanted to cover is how should we offer the gift? In what manner? And I love the epistle that Dan read to us today. The epistle offers us several clues actually. Okay, it gave the list. If you contribute, give with liberality. And that means be generous. You know, don't be... Dig a little deeper. You know, go the extra mile. Give somebody the benefit of the doubt. I love this second one that the epistle mentioned. If you give aid, do it with zeal. You know, that's not a word we hear a lot in our culture anymore. Zeal. You know, get fired up. Do it. You know? And acts of mercy with cheerfulness. I don't see Stella here today, but, you know, I was thinking, Stella, she just always has this bright smile on her face, you know, and she's always running around. She works so hard. She gets here really early on Sunday mornings doing stuff, and she does all the ministries for the homeless, and she's just got a great attitude, and it's very infectious. Let your love be genuine. The last one that really jumped at me was, and this is beautiful, outdo one another. Outdo one another. You know, I was one beautiful thing that I've been able to experience, you know, sometimes there's the law of unintended consequences. Usually we think of that as the negative things. Well, a positive things happen too. When I'm in the choir, which when I'm not at the altar, I sing in the choir, and I get to stand back there, and so I get to see something that a lot of you folks don't get to see. And it goes like this. It plays out every Sunday. So Sophie Larson, she sits in the very back row right in front of the choir. And she and her friend Annie sit back there. They're both avid, voracious readers. And then usually in front of them are the Rutledge girls, who are artists. And then in front of them, you get the Robinson girls. And then sometimes the Marhofer girls go over there. And a lot of the little kids tend to congregate back there. And the Sophie and a few of the other girls, they help the little kids back there. It's just a beautiful thing. And they help the kids, the little kids want to be in church. They let them color, and they give the parents a much needed break from crowding the kids. But also, this is what happens. When the embrace of peace happens, the girls all go over there and they hug each other. And it's a beautiful thing to see. You know, a lot of times teenage girls can be a little bit catty, and these girls aren't catty. And it's this huge spectrum. You got artists, you got book readers, you got ballet girls, and they like, you can see in their faces, they like being together. And I don't know if you've noticed, but the little Sunday school room off of the kitchen, you know, a lot of those girls go and they eat lunch together during coffee hour. And I'm like, gosh, what a beautiful thing. So, girls, I'm going to charge you, do not get a hard heart. You keep those soft hearts. That is a gift from God, that you need to foster it, and you need to just help it grow. And you guys are a great example to the little kids and to the rest of us. So, the last couple things that were mentioned in the epistle are also beautiful. Be aglow with the Spirit. Be aglow with the Spirit, and never flag in zeal. And I was thinking maybe some of the younger guys, Nicodemus, John Cassian, you know, flag in zeal. It might not be a word that you guys are used to hearing, but, you know, it just means you're pooped. You're tired out. You're out of gas. And you never want to let that zeal die. We want to use those gifts and be, you know, really just excel in it. So, brothers and sisters, in conclusion, the church really does need your gift, no matter what you have to offer. The church needs it. You can be paint, you can be a nail, you can be carpet, you can even be the glue under the carpet. All of us are needed. And so may God help all of us to use our gift with zeal, that we may be aglow with the Holy Spirit to His glory. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. With song.
Let the guardian always cry, thy might be ascribed glory unto thee, to the Father.
baptized into the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Thank you.
authorities and our armed forces everywhere. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne, for Wanda, Teresa, Natalia, Noel, for the newborn James Asterius and his family, for the newborn Eleanor, Christine, and her family, for Kimberly, for Dr. Luke and Ruth, for the Deacon Thomas and Wendy, for Ryan, for Andrew and Stephanie, for Amanda, Stephanie, and Aubrey, that the Lord grant them mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, and especially for Lisa, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Peace be to all.
And to my spirit.
with one accord we may confess.
Thank you.
remembrance, therefore, this saving commandment, and all those things which have come to pass for us, the cross, the grave, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the session at the right hand, and the glorious and second advent. Thine own of thine own, we offer unto thee, in behalf of all and for all.
Receiving them upon his holy, most heavenly, and ideal altar, has a savor of spiritual sweetness. to sit down upon us in return of his divine grace and the grace of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Vouchsafe, O Lord, that with boldness and without condemnation we may dare call upon thee, the Heavenly Father, the Heavenly Goddess Father, and you say,
Jesus,
principle that you're here. We do have to inform you, though, at this point, that only people who are chrismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church in good standing may partake of Holy Communion this morning.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you. You're up.
Prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. of Egypt, Let us go forth in peace. And sanctify those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not who hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all the people. For every good and perfect gift is from above and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.